What's up guys, Okan here, back at it with another video. Now, this time we're going to be talking about and reviewing Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart. I know this game came out months ago, and I've had it since its release actually, but I've really taken my time with playing it as you can tell. I just beat it this past Sunday, and I gotta say, wow, this game is a real treat. Before I start, I do want to mention off the bat that this is not my game footage. I did get this off of YouTube, and I will link below whose game footage this is. Shout out GameRanks for all your great footage. But without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the video. Now, first things first, how did I feel about this game? Overall, I thought it was amazing. Very good action adventure platformer, without a doubt. And I think I want to start with how it looks overall. So the animation is insanely good, and you can see Ratchet and Rivet's fur so clearly, and it looks really amazing. The facial animations are also very nice to look at, and seeing the expressions on the Lombax's face, and even on the robots like Clank and Kit, it's really nice to look at. The animation when you use different weapons was also unique to each one, and they had a different look to them as well. And as well as that, the animation when Rifts would open also looked really nice. So I was really impressed with everything that I saw on the screen, and this is what next gen is supposed to look like without a doubt. And as we know, Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart was one of the first games that was shown off when the PS5 was announced. So we knew going into this that this game would be sort of a visual treat and kind of a performance shower for the PS5, and it was definitely. So I think this game just on all fronts just really shows off what the system can do visually and just technically as well. So next thing I want to talk about is the tether glove, which is a new mechanic in this game, and it shows off how quickly you can move from one area to another in the game, and in doing that as well also shows off the PS5's capabilities a bit more, and the way it increases traversal speed is really cool. And speaking of traversal speed, the way you use the hurl shot in this game, which is a mechanic that lets you basically spin around really fast around a grapple hook and then shoot to another side of the map really fast, it's basically something that's really helpful in the game, and it just shows how fast everything can work out in this. And rails to grind on were also very fun. Grinding on rails is nothing new for the series, but including the other methods of traversal in the middle of this all helped it feel a lot less mundane and samey overall. So the main plot of the game is that Ratchet and Clank must basically stop Dr. Nefarious once again, as he'd use a new machine called the Dimensionator. Very dumb name, but it is a very comic booky type of game, so it makes sense. But he'd use the Dimensionator to create a dimension in which he reigns supreme and all bow before him. But they meet Rivet and Kit along the way, and those two must also join them in their mission to take down Nefarious on this wild adventure. The story wasn't what I would call breathtaking or breaking any boundaries or extremely fresh either. However, it was definitely serviceable, and it was enough to keep me interested without a doubt. And there's a big twist a third of the way through, and I thought it was enough to keep me going and wanting to see the ending, so I'm glad I saw it all the way through without a doubt as well. Combat and gameplay was amazing, from the fights with the nefarious robots to all the different types of enemies you had, to the high speed chase sequences on the speedles, which are little speed beetles that they had in the game, and the jet boots that helped you speed really fast as well. Everything about this game feels good, and I like that the boss battles feel so intense and somewhat challenging at times. I say it's a really good feeling when you're playing the game overall. And also, as well as that, the guns all feel different and unique, and with the DualSense, it amplifies that feeling when you pull the trigger to a different degree. If you pull the trigger halfway, you only get half of the weapon's ability. Like, some weapons will only shoot so far, they'll create a shield and just do that, but then if you pull the trigger all the way, the shield will blow up in the enemy's face, or the weapon will shoot even further or shoot more than it did initially. And it's really cool when it's in practice. So the writing of these characters was nice as well. Let's start with the new ones overall. Rivet was a good contrast to how upbeat and optimistic Ratchet always feels for the most part. She was more cautious and not negative, but more pessimistic at times. But her characterization and growth by the end of the game was really nice to see, so I appreciated that. Kit felt the same way for me. She was down on herself a lot and felt completely different than Clank. But it made sense because each of these characters was the other's dimensional counterpart. Ratchet and Clank were pretty much the same as always, although there was a bit of reluctance on Ratchet's part due to a certain plot thread I don't want to spoil for those that haven't played the game, but it made you look at Ratchet a bit differently because he didn't usually show those type of emotions, so it showed that Insomniac was taking some risk with this one in terms of storytelling. And I think overall, I guess my only complaint would be that after pausing for a while, like, I would pause the game and then I'd come back to it, my game would freeze. And the characters would be moving, but I wasn't able to control them. So it was a little bit weird, and I had to reload the game for it to start working properly. It only happened once or twice, so it wasn't the end of the world, but it was a bit strange and not something I would expect on this brand new console with this brand new game. But other than that, I don't think I had really any complaints in regards to the title. So all in all, guys, I have to say that Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart is almost a perfect gaming experience. With the tight controls and gameplay and graphics and the amazing animation, Rift Apart becomes another slam dunk for Insomniac Studios. With the Spider-Man games and the Ratchet and Clank games being as amazing as they are, Insomniac is slowly becoming one of my favorite developers. And with no crunch apparently while making this game, that makes it even better overall, so shout out to them for that. I would definitely recommend this game to anyone who is on the fence about playing it. But thinking I'm going to go ahead and end the video there, guys. Appreciate the support as always, and love everybody that watches these videos. Y'all are great. Shout out to y'all. Yeah, this game was pretty dope, and I can't wait to see what they do with the future of this series. There's only so many places they can go because this type of gameplay is like kind of specific, and it's like I wonder what they're going to do next. The Rifts were a good addition to the game, like I said previously, but it'll be interesting to see what they do next and what they're capable of doing with the power of the PS5. But enough on that. Like I said, I was ending the video. Thanks for watching as always. Appreciate you guys and your support. If you did enjoy this video, go ahead and like, subscribe, and stay tuned to see what type of content I take on next time. Later. Bye.